Fossil fuels have powered transportation for about 100 years. But today, that's changing.
We're now in the midst of this huge revolution, the first time in a century that we're actually changing the method of propulsion.
The transportation sector is moving away from gas and starting to rely more on electricity. This will transform how all kinds of things move. And that matters because
transportation is a huge contributor to climate change.
Worldwide, the transportation sector is the second largest source of CO2 emissions. And in the US, it's the leading source of greenhouse gas emissions.
So most forms of transportation run on some sort of combustion.
Gasoline, diesel, or jet fuel is burned.
And that creates heat energy, which is then converted into kinetic energy to move the wheels.
But it also puts a lot of pollutants into the atmosphere. Electricity powered by renewables is one alternative to gasoline or diesel fuels.
We're really looking at electrified vehicles to solve the problem.
Electrified vehicles are on a spectrum. At one end, you have hybrids.
A hybrid vehicle is a combination of an electric motor with a battery and a normal gasoline engine.
And at the other end,
there's a battery electric vehicle, which is purely run on electricity. That needs to be plugged in, of course, to recharge.
Hybrids have been around for a while, but zero-emission battery electric vehicles are becoming more popular today.
Apple and electric cars
will be electric.
Electric cars and trucks.
We're really seeing battery electric vehicles take off in China, also in Europe as well. So the U.S. is lagging on this technology, despite the fact that we have Tesla, which is, you know, the best known electric vehicle company.
Remember, fossil fuels power more than just cars.
So electrification is spreading to all kinds of modes of transportation. Of course, we've seen light rail systems in many cities, and these are generally electric. In Seattle, they've launched an electric ferry service. And we're looking at even the beginning of electrification in aviation.
But before electricity can power more vehicles, jet planes, and ships, batteries need improvement.
Batteries are heavy and they don't have a ton of energy density, which means you have to have a very big battery in a plane to try to get it to go very far. It's just not practical.
Maritime ships have the same problem, and so do some heavy rig trucks. So until we can pack more energy into our batteries, we're seeing smaller modes of transport using electricity, like cars, ferries, and brand new modes of transportation. We'll see more and more EVs on the roads soon. But in the US, they still need to be more attractive to consumers.
Right now, there are some tax incentives for the purchase of EVs, but they're limited. Both the Biden administration and the industry have talked about extending those, making them more available, making them last longer, so that more people can buy an electric vehicle. There'll also be incentives for charging stations, money to support that, because it costs money to put in these charging stations, including in your home.
These incentives could really help automakers and consumers make the switch toward electric vehicles.
I think that by the end of the decade, we will see maybe a third of all cars sold would be electric. It's really going to happen fast.
Transportation is in the middle of a historic shift away from fossil fuels. Electricity will power how people and goods move in the future. Let's review. We've been gradually electrifying vehicles for a while, but today, zero-emission EVs are taking off. China and Europe are ahead of the US when it comes to EVs. And people are still trying to figure out how to power heavy modes of transportation, like airplanes and ships.
100 years ago, electric vehicles were competing with combustion engines and steam engines. We went with the combustion engine, but now we're facing this climate change problem and we have to change again.
And while this could profoundly reduce transportation emissions in the future, it's not the only solution for decarbonizing the planet.